Alhamdulillah, all praise be to Allah. Salutations and peace be upon our Master and Beloved, the Messenger of Allah, and upon his family and companions, and those who are loyal. How sweet it is for us to repeat mention of our Rasul, our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mentioning him is sweeter than honey and sweeter than every joy in this dunya, in this world. The mention and remembrance of the Beloved of Allah, may the peace and blessings be upon him and his family and companions. Let us look at an example of his character and qualities and his method of interaction in guiding and calling creation to Allah. One of those who had severe enmity and caused great harm to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a man from Najd called Thumama ibn Uthal. He was a leader of his people. He showed a lot of enmity and hostility to the Messenger of Allah. He had intercepted some Muslim caravans. In fact, he had murdered some Muslims. Now, during an expedition, some Sahaba caught him. These Sahaba didn't know who he was. They brought him to the Prophet's city and held him until the Messenger of Allah would come and give judgment. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came, he recognized him. He asked, "Thumama?" He said, "Yes." The Prophet said, "Tie him to a pillar of the mosque." They entered the mosque and tied him to a pillar there. All affairs of the Beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam are amazing and pure wisdom. In these episodes, we are merely skimming through them. Otherwise, if we wanted to study and examine carefully the benefits that are acquired from each situation, we would spend many hours doing so. So when the Prophet said, "Tie Thumama to a pillar in his mosque," he wanted Thumama to observe. The Prophet said to him, "Thumama, what do you say?" Thumama replied, "O Muhammad, if you kill me, you will be killing someone whose blood deserves to be shed," meaning you have a right to kill me. "And if you want blood money, then ask however much you want. If you do me a favor and are generous, then you will be generous to someone who recognizes generosity and would duly return it." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned away from him and left him and went. A whole day passed, and the Prophet would come to his mosque and pray with the Sahaba, his companions, and Thumama would witness incredible scenes. This wasn't a drama, this wasn't a play. He saw scenes of beauty, of spirituality, purity, love, self-discipline, and turning to God that he had never imagined in his life. When the second day came, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam repeated to Thumama what he had said on the first day, and Thumama replied as he had done the day before. On the third day, the Messenger of Allah, Rasulullah, said the same, and Thumama replied as he had replied before. The Sahaba thought that the Prophet will say, "Take him and strike his neck." But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Set him free. Go, O Thumama, you are free." The companions were amazed. What was going on? How could he sallallahu alaihi wasallam release him just like that? Thumama went to the nearest garden. He went to a well. He took a bath and he came once more to the mosque. This time, Thumama entered with a countenance, a face different from the one with which he had left. He said, "O Muhammad, I now bear witness that there is no God but Allah and that you are the Messenger of Allah." The Prophet said, "Why didn't you bear witness from the beginning?" He said, "So that people don't think that I became Muslim out of fear of the sword and of being killed. I only came of my own desire." So the Prophet marveled at him and was happy with him. This Thumama, on his own accord, then blocked the way for the Meccans, the enemies of the Muslims. He didn't let any of the caravans of Najd reach Mecca until Abu Sufyan and the pagans, the mushrikun of Mecca, sought help from Rasulullah to ask Thumama to set them free. When, ironically, these same pagans were the ones who had placed an embargo and cut off supplies from the Prophet for 3 years. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt pity for the children of Mecca. He told Thumama, "O Thumama, leave people's food. Leave people's nutrition, for there are children and women amongst them." So he had them released, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. Such are the scales of mercy that Allah filled his Prophet's heart with, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, such that these rough and coarse and harsh hearts began to be guided by his heart. We ask Allah to bestow us from this mercy and light that He bestowed upon His beloved Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
Yeah.